And moving on and getting you updates from Bengal, just minutes after West Bengal Governor Mr. Tripathi held meetings with Prime Minister Modi and Home Minister Amit Shah. West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee now hitting out at the BJP, also taking a dig at the centre. And I quote here, she says, "I will not tolerate anyone trying to topple my government. State election will happen in 2021. Anyone trying to break my government will not be spared. I will not tolerate this fake propaganda. An injured tiger is more dangerous than a dead tiger." This is Mamata Banerjee, quote unquote, addressing a news conference in Bengal. Remember, there have been hectic developments taking place since this morning. A BJP delegation is likely to hold a press conference in Bengal over the political killings for which the BJP has blamed TMC. In the national capital, MHA today issued an advisory. And these are pictures of West Bengal Governor Keshari Nath Tripathi after his meeting with Prime Minister Modi and Home Minister Amit Shah. And now, at a time when BJP leaders are demanding president's rule be imposed in West Bengal, Mamata Banerjee hitting out and saying, "I will not tolerate anyone trying to topple my government." Shreyasi, my colleague, now joins me with more details. Shreyasi, why does Mamata Banerjee believe that somebody is trying to topple a government?
Well, a very sharp reaction there coming in from the Chief Minister in the backdrop of her administration meeting that was taking place at the State Secretary. The reason why she is responding to that is because a host of BJP leaders, not only MPs, have been demanding president's rule here in West Bengal in the backdrop of the kind of violence that West Bengal has been witnessing on the onset of the Lok Sabha elections. There was violence during the polls. There is now post-poll violence that has completely gripped the state. And time and again, the BJP leadership here in West Bengal, including BJP MP Babul Supriyo, has been asking for president's rule here in West Bengal to maintain the law and order situation, saying that Mamata Banerjee government has completely failed in containing the law and order situation here. And thus, this was Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee not mincing her words, attacking back the centre without naming any political party, saying any party that tries to topple her government, it won't be spared. And this is not the first time Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee has given out an ultimatum. Earlier also on the occasion of Eid, she has
said... And very curious response from Nitish, because on one hand, from Mamata, I beg your pardon, Shreyasi, because on one hand, Mamata Banerjee is attacking the BJP and the centre, and on the other, when she was asked a question about JDU and Nitish Kumar, she said, in fact, Mamata Banerjee went on to thank Nitish Kumar. She was asked that JDU has decided that they will partner NDA only in Bihar.
Well, Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee still trying to put the opposition in one room, bring that united opposition. Still, after the defeat in the Lok Sabha elections, Nitish Kumar was someone who was not a part of the Mahagathbandhan clearly. But now with Nitish Kumar yesterday at his national executive saying that how JDU will be fighting alone in the assembly elections and those segments, Mamata Banerjee feeling that if this model of where the state fights alone in the where the main ruling party of a state fights alone in the state, while in the centre they could be in a tie with the with the NDA government, this kind of a model is something that Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee has been batting since day one. And of course, we have to keep in mind that Prashant Kishore is also now advising Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee on this post-poll debacle that has happened here in West Bengal. There was a meeting at the State Secretariat, which was chaired by Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee, where Prashant Kishore made a surprise visit at along
right.
with Shreyasi,
just hold
Banerjee.
Your thoughts. I believe there's a BJP protest planned just where you are standing. But three quick updates for our viewers. Mamata Banerjee has taken pot shots at the BJP and has also attacked centre by saying, "I will not allow anyone to topple my government. Elections will take place only in 2021. Then, when she was asked a question about JDU and Nitish Kumar, she thanked Nitish Kumar, and many are reading this as a sign of a new Mamata Nitish bonhomie. And Tamal has just sent us this update that Mamata will also be installing the Vidya Sagar bus tomorrow. That's happening at around 2:30 in the afternoon tomorrow. Shreshi.
Well, Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee will be installing the bus of Vidya Sagar tomorrow at around 1. It's going to be a mega event here in Kolkata. It's going to start with a padayatra and then she will be restoring that statue. While a bus was vandalized during that rally where Amit Shah was here in Kolkata, tomorrow the West Bengal government, especially the education department, will be installing the entire figure of Vidya Sagar here in Kolkata. It's going to be a big political showdown because we've seen the kind of political war of words that had unfolded between the BJP and TMC over that particular incident. But again, keeping in mind why Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee reacted in that particular way, saying that if anyone tries to topple her government, it won't be nice. Because we've seen the kind of TMC leaders joining BJP. There have been several councillors, MLAs, who have shifted to the BJP, and the number games are changing here in West Bengal as well. So after the Lok Sabha elections, the political temperature here in West Bengal is only rising, with of course the political violence that has been being reported from various parts with BJP and TMC at war.
Right, Shreshi, continue to track the developments and updates for us. We'll keep coming back to you for more as we go along through the day.